अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज़ फ्यूचर टेंस। प्रीवियसली वी लर्न अबाउट प्रेजेंट टेंस एंड पास्ट टेंस। वेल स्टूडेंट्स, अ सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस इज़ अ वर्ब टेंस दैट इज़ यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट थिंग्स दैट हैवंट हैपेंड येट। इट इज़ यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट एन एक्शन और कंडीशन दैट विल बिगिन एंड एंड इन फ्यूचर। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फ्यूचर टेंस। सब्जेक्ट प्लस द ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब विल एंड शैल, एंड वी हैव गॉट verb in the base form, that is in the first form of the verb. I will go to Thailand. I is the subject, will and shall is used, will is used with I, and go is the first form, that is base form of the verb, and the rest of the sentence is to Thailand. It is in the affirmative or we can say positive form. The negative sentence of simple future tense is I will not go to Thailand, and similarly the interrogative, will you go to Thailand. Now from this diagram it is clearly shown that the simple future tense is used for an action that will occur in the future. As you can see, with the base form they have used the auxiliary verb will, and it will be given in the future activity for the future tense. Now the usage of simple future tense along with the examples, that is the situations in which you can use simple future tense. For actions, describe at the moment of speech. I have a toothache, that is at the moment of speech he has got toothache, and I will take some medicine. So he is giving his future plan that he will take the medicine in future. For unplanned future actions, winter will come soon. Winter will come soon, it is not yet planned that what will going to happen in winter, so it is for unplanned future. For offering, asking, for request, promising, ordering or threatening. I am afraid we will get wet, so this is a we can say in fear that he is going to be wet, but it's not yet happened now. For unpreventable actions in future, there's which you cannot escape from, that is summer will come soon, summer will definitely going to come soon, so this is unpreventable action. With conditional time and purpose clauses, when I arrive at home I will call you, so this was a condition when he is going to arrive. Unless he arrive at home he cannot tell you. For thoughts, predications, assumptions, and sureness, fears about future, I promise I won't tell this to anyone. This is a future in this is a promise in future. Now this is just a picture to give you an idea about future tense conversation. A small dialogue in simple future tense. Are you coming to my party? She is talking about the time which is going to happen next. I didn't know about it. Sure, I'll come. This is a simple dialogue in future tense. Now some more examples of simple future tense. The Moscow State Circus will perform in Cheltenham next year. We will celebrate our anniversary by flying to New York. Always do your best. What you plant now, you will harvest later. What we achieve inwardly will change out reality. So this is just some kind of quotations or some sentences to show the future tenses. Now here is the slide to show the three forms of sentences, that is positive, negative, interrogative, using simple future tense. I will come, I will not come, will I come, you will come, you will not come, will you come, and so on, with all the pronouns he, she, I and you. They are using it, the simple future tense, in positive, negative and question form of the sentences. Now come to the future continuous tense. Now this slide shows you the structure of future continuous tense, that is you are going to use the auxiliary verb will be along with the present participle. I will be fishing tomorrow and will be singing later. So this is an ongoing activity in the future. Now here is we can say the future progressive tense or the future continuous tense is used for an ongoing action that will occur in the future. For example, John will be baking a cake and they will be painting the fence. Then again a slide to show the positive, negative and interrogative forms of sentences using future continuous tenses. That is, the structure is first we give the subject plus will be the auxiliary verb, and we use the fourth form of the verb, that is first form of the verb plus ing. It will be storming tomorrow. It will not be storming tomorrow, negative sentence. Will it be storming tomorrow? Now here again the usage, that is situations in which we can use future continuous tense. First is to describe interrupted actions in the future. When you come tomorrow, they will be playing tennis. So this was an uninterrupted action, that is playing tennis, and it is in the future tense. Next is to express actions in progress at a specific time in the future. At 12 o'clock tomorrow, we will be having lunch at school. This is the specific time you are mentioning, but in the future. To refer to actions that are happening now and expected to continue in the future. Unfortunately, sea levels will still be rising in 20 years. This is a continuous future tense. To ask a question politely about the future. Will you be bringing your friend to the party tonight? So he's asking about the future scenario, that is, in the party, are you going to bring your friend? So this is the kind of question which is being politely asked using the future tense. To emphasize future plans and intentions, that is, he'll be coming to visit us next week. This is his intention to come to us. To describe atmosphere in the future, when I arrive at the party, everybody will be celebrating. Some will be dancing. So this is a sort of atmosphere or the theme that's going to happen in future at that particular time and moment of the party. To express parallel actions or series of parallel actions in the future, like we did in past tense, she will be watching TV and he will be cooking dinner. Now let's learn about the future perfect tense. Well, you can see this is again a self-explanatory and well-elaborative picture of future perfect tense, showing you the structure, that is, will have an auxiliary verb will be used along with the past participle, right? So past participle will be used with this future perfect tense will have, that is the third form of the verb. Now here it is more clear from these three sentences. Subject plus will plus have plus past participle, that is, he will have done it by this evening. So done is the third form of the verb or past participle, which is going to be used with will have. He will not have done it by this evening. Will he have done it by this evening? So along with the subject, you are going to use will have definitely, and you are going to use the third form of the verb, that is done, which is the third form of the verb of do did done, or you can say the past participle. Now again a slide to show the usage and the examples of tenses. To describe interrupted actions in the future. When you come home tomorrow, they will be playing tennis. So he is talking about this usage of the sentences. To express actions in progress at a specific time in future, at 12 o'clock tomorrow, we will be having lunch. And to refer to actions that are happening new. So this is all about the usage and the example which I have already told you. Now please come to the future perfect continuous tense. Again the structure, here the addition of been, been, been is visible to you. Subject plus will have plus been. So as I have already told you that whenever you have got a perfect continuous tense, whether it is a present perfect continuous tense, a past perfect continuous tense, or a future perfect continuous tense, what you have to do is you are surely going to use this been, been, and in some cases and mostly in the sentences, we are going to mention the time, that is time duration or the point of time. For time duration, we are going to use for, and for a point of time, we use since. Like in this example, I will have been eating vegetables for 3 months. I is the subject, will have been is surely going to be added in this future perfect continuous tense as an auxiliary verb. Eating is the fourth form of the verb, and vegetables for 3 months, and for is used to show the duration of time, that is for the whole 3 months, first month, second month, third month, for the whole 3 months, during that time period he is going to eat vegetables. The negative form of the sentence is, I won't have been eating vegetables for 3 months. Will you have been eating vegetables for 3 months? Now again the examples, that is the usage of future perfect tense, to show that something will continue up until a particular event or time in future. Like James will have been teaching at the university more than a year by the time he leaves for the next university. So इसमें ये बताना चाह रहे हैं कि the action of teaching will be done, will be continued in the future perfect tense until unless he leaves from here. To talk about something that finishes just before another time or action, I will be tired when I get home because we will have been walking for over an hour. So he is talking about that action which is going to be finished just before another time of action is placed. So finally, some more examples of future perfect continuous tense. I will have been playing for 2 hours by breakfast. By the time the boat arrives, they will have been living without proper food for 2 weeks. Shop that will have been running for 3 or 2 years by then will have to close down. They will have been driving for 10 hours by the time they arrive in Scotland. If it rains again tomorrow, then it will have been raining for 3 days. He will be agitated when he arrives because he will have been working for 10 hours. So it's all about future perfect continuous tense. Thank you for watching. Hope you have understood all.